Welcome, and thank you all for being a part of WFTDA's 14th tournament season. On behalf of the Women's Flat Track Derby Association Board of Directors, I'd like to start by thanking the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex and all of the fans who have joined us here and online at WFTDA.tv for the 2019 International WFTDA Playoffs in Winston-Salem, North Carolina.
The WFTDA wishes to join Greensboro Roller Derby in paying tribute to the generations who contributed their hopes, dreams, and energy that led to this moment at the 2019 International WFTDA Playoffs in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. Nearly 60 years ago, four students, Joseph McNeil, Franklin McCain, Azell Blair Jr., and David Richmond, began a sit-in at a whites-only Greensboro lunch counter in protest of segregation, kicking off a series of ultimately successful sit-ins at lunch counters across the country that proved instrumental to the civil rights movement. Just 3 years ago, the Public Facilities Privacy and Security Act, also known as HB 2, was signed into North Carolina law, denying transgender individuals safe access to public bathroom facilities. Without the sustained protests and boycotts that erupted nationwide and statewide, and ultimately resulted in the law's partial repeal, transgender people, such as myself, would effectively be outlawed from participating in public society. Anti-transgender legislation policies persist as North Carolina state law to this day. We stand on a civil rights battleground, and without the sacrifices of those who stood in defiance of oppression, racism, and discrimination, many of us would not be here today. The WFTDA stands in solidarity with all who fight to expose truth, all who fight for liberation, and all who fight for a more just world. We seek to atone for the injustices we have been complicit in and ask our membership to stand with us. The WFTDA recognizes that we stand on unceded land stolen from the indigenous population of North America, historically known to some First Nations peoples as Turtle Island. As such, I would like to introduce James Stevens from the Native American Student Association at UNCG.
Thank you all for being here. Kai hua mani min kila kewa, mi mahalo asaponi ye song. Mi hen la seha la ke wo e hung, wi tong mi hen la ke wo hi kung, mi wa nung hata gan. My name is James Stevens. My Tutelo name is He Comes From the Water, or Kaihuamani, and I'm a Halawasaponi person. My mother's name is Woman Laughing, and my grandmother's name is Dear Woman, and we are the original people, Miwanung Hatakan. The recitation I gave at the opening is called the Ganahenyu, or the Great Law of Peace. My elders taught me that whenever we gather in groups of three or more, there should always be a moment of thanksgiving. Another thing I was taught, and that we do as Native people, is to always introduce yourself in your traditional way, especially when you're claiming your people. We're taught this because in our community, you do not exist in a vacuum or as a singular. You see, to be a Native person is to belong to your community, not only who you claim, but who claims you. I can say I'm Halawasaponi all day long, but what's more important is that Halawasaponis say I'm Halawasaponi. My people know me. This is what we call kinship. This value of kinship extends beyond the citizens of our tribes. We have kinship with everything. Our oral history tells us that we are kin to the animals that walk on the earth, the grasses of the fields, the trees of the forest, and the earth. All the mountains, hills, valleys, rivers, and streams, we are all connected. This concept of interconnectedness has existed in my community since time began, but it's only recently that, quote, Western society, or society born out of Europe, has developed the theory of evolution and demonstrated through Western science our interconnectedness. So why do I bring all this up, right? We're at a roller derby tournament in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. Aren't all the native people gone? Well, I'd hope you know by the fact that I'm standing before you as a citizen of a North Carolina tribe that indigenous people of this land, the land we are on today, are very much still alive and exist with a culture distinct from the rest of American society. But I digress. I'm here to acknowledge those communities who belong to this land, and I do not believe that I, as a native person, can do that justly without sharing some of my worldview. When Wahanaka, which means smoke men in our language, first arrived at our shores over 500 years ago, we didn't have a concept of land ownership. We can't own land any more than we can own our brothers and sisters, or cousins, or aunties, or uncles. And so my people, and I know this to be true for all the people of this great state, never ceded nor sold our land. Our land was taken by force through the decimation of our villages, enslavement of our men, and other unspeakable means. Somehow, after more than 500 years of settler colonial violence, my people have survived, but many communities have not been so fortunate. And so, it is in this land acknowledgement that I want to recognize those communities which are no longer with us, who came from the land we are standing on today, and offer a moment of silence. Those communities are Bear River, Cape Fear, Cory, Croatan, Eno, Hatteras, Kiawi, Machapunga, Moratok, Nusiok, Pamlico, Shikori, Sisipaha, Sugary, Watery, Weapemeyok, Wakan, Yagkin, and Yeopim. And also, I'd like to recognize those communities which have survived and still maintain our culture and traditions, especially the Okanichi Band of the Saponi Nation, which is the most local tribe to Winston-Salem, in addition to the Koheri, Lumbee, Meharan, Halawa Saponi, Waccamaw Suwan, Saponi Nation, and Eastern Band Cherokee. As I close out this land acknowledgement, I want to invite you to consider, if you haven't ever before, what is your position in the Western Hemisphere, or what we call Turtle Island? For most of you in attendance, that question and your subsequent answer might be very uncomfortable, but it doesn't have to be. Through awareness of your positionality, you can begin to unlearn internalized settler colonial ideas about indigenous people as part of the historic past or segregated from the rest of society, and start to include us in dialogues that are happening on our land. We are modern, we are urban, and we are still here. Ekoe pilahuk, thank you.
We would like to thank all of our staff and volunteers, but especially our officials crews led by Chunk Rock Girl and Danger Muffin. Games tournament Games tournament oversight, Nell Baum. Ringster team manager, John Obst. The announcer crew led by Steffi Skyscraper. Blaze Streaming Media and the WFTDA.TV broadcast crew. Our WFTDA compliance manager, Roly Cannoli, medical support staff, and volunteers. Our marketing team, led by iSmack. the talented photographers who shot the tournament, our on-site WFTDA staff, Erica Vanstone, Susie Slam, Dottie Damage, Mia Culprit, and Rachel Novak, our incredibly supportive venue who have gone the extra mile to accommodate us. And last but not least, we would like to extend a huge thank you to our host leads, Buster and Roby. Greensboro Roller Derby and all their volunteers have been phenomenal hosts this weekend, going above and beyond. We would also like to extend our congratulations to all of the teams that participated in this weekend's tournament. Dos por cuatro, Roller Derby. Angel City Derby. Atlanta Roller Derby. Bay Area Derby. Bear City Roller Derby. Helsinki Roller Derby. Lum Roller Girls. Paris Roller Girls. Rainy City Roller Derby. Santa Cruz Derby Girls. Texas Roller Girls. And the Windy City Rollers. This tournament was made possible in part by support from our sponsors, including Derby City Skates, Derby Girl Designs, Strong Athletics, Texas Roller Girls, Left Turn Clothing, S1, Rydell, Adam Skates, and RollerCon for providing each of our top three Champs Teams charter members with 2020 RollerCon MVP passes. It is now my honor to introduce the tournament MVP. Each MVP is chosen by the WFTDA Board of Directors, both on-site and watching from home, and this is so tough because there are so many great skaters here. Ultimately, this player embodies the WFTDA values by being a real, strong, athletic, and revolutionary individual on and off the track. These characteristics include being a leader, a strong presence, an amazing athlete, and an inspiration within the roller derby community and our sport. Our MVP this weekend is a triple threat. While I could talk about the dozens of points she has racked up this weekend or the way in which she can lock down a jammer virtually unaccompanied, I would like to instead take this time to gush about her offense. The precision with which the skater deploys offense is unrivaled, and her communication with her teammates seems nearly supernatural. In a matter of seconds, this skater seems to identify an opening, create an opportunity, and alert the rest of her team, getting her jammer through the pack before her opponents even have a chance to react. She is a consummate team player and a burst of energy, often known to be the first to celebrate her team's successes. She is a ubiquitous presence around the roller derby community, and as we saw earlier today, a hell of a class act. It is my supreme privilege to introduce your tournament MVP for 2019, the year of the pineapple, to Blackjack of Atlanta Roller Derby.
Got to get all the photos, you know. There we go. Congratulations again to our tournament MVP, Blackjack. It is now my pleasure to bring to you the medal placement teams for the 2019 International WFTDA Playoffs in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. Get everyone in place here. So placing third in the playoffs is Dos Por Cuatro. Seated number four. As they enter the playoff, they're ranked number 12th in the world. It is 03 Demis. Demis. Put the accent on the wrong place. 14 Mandarina. 1807 Dixon. 24 La Drecho. 26 Tropical Mechanica. 265 Lulazan. 3 Carla. 35 Kiresha. 45, Makey Lambera. Number 7, Rasho. 84, Persephone. Number 9, Loba. And 99, Chinaski. Hailing from Buenos Aires, Argentina, here is Dos Por Cuatro. In placing number 2 in the playoffs is the Texas Roller Girls Texecutioners. They are ranked 6 in the world, and they are 050 Bad Juju, 1010 Bazooka Bubblebum, number 12 DeBella DeBall, number 14 Cold Case, number 1693 Legal Knievel, 202 Freight Train, 226 Terabyte, 2581 Root of All Evil, 27 Peace War, 300 Chris Rajo, 32 Captain Sassy, 34 Bo Jackson, 420 Stoneher, 55 Hoss the Boss, 69 Dardar Binks, 82 Marisi Livin, and number 9 Nine Lives. Hailing from Austin, Texas, it's the Texas Roller Girls Texecutioners. And our first place team for the playoffs is Angel City Derby Hollywood Scarlets. They were seeded number 2 as they came into the playoffs, ranked number 7 in the world and placed number 1. 1031, Whiskey Von Sweets. 2, Juana Tees. 20, DeColdis Winters. 26, Schadenfreude. 28, Death Down Under. Number 3, Soledad. 39, Cracker Jack. 422, Lo Bencourt. 507, Rachel Rotten. 512, Pearl Jam. 5150, Darby Dagger. 65, Smash. 664 Psycho, 777 Perfect, and 88 Tui Lion. Hailing from Los Angeles, California, it's Angel City Derby, the Hollywood Scarlets. You know how we like photos, y'all. I mean, gotta do this. So So this is your first, second, and third place team guaranteed a spot in Montreal. Hope you'll all join us there. Hope you'll also join us at the after party. Let's give a big round of applause for our first, second, and third place winners at the 2019 WFTDA playoffs here in Winston-Salem. We thank you for your time and your support. I've been your MC, Rippy Longstocking, and I'm going to sign off now.